In this episode, I note some of the negative effects of tourism while on holidays in Bali. These problems include pollution, especially rubbish and other debris on the beach. The second issue I look at is traffic congestion, and the third issue I examine is the issue of land and water use. In this case, hotels and the local community are in conflict about access to the beach, clean drinking water, and land.
Kuta Beach, Bali is where I'm now. Kuta, a famous location for Australian holiday makers. I've just sat here. The beach, you can see, is not very great. In fact, the travel professor is a bit disappointed with Bali. I was expecting white sandy beaches, blue, crystal blue waters. Maybe this was the case a long time ago. But now it's very polluted. The sand, there's lots of rubbish. Even the people have tried to make an effort by cleaning up some of the rubbish. But many holidaymakers, and then up on the main street, you've got shop after shop selling the same sort of touristy stuff, bintang singlets. On the beach, I've just managed to get rid of all the people trying to sell me stuff, from ice creams to beer to wooden carvings, massages. So this is the other side of Bali, so the very touristy side. It's a case, and there's been a lot of research into how Bali, and particularly this area around Kuta, has been an example of poor tourism planning and management. Very congested traffic, lots of pollution, not very holistic sort of planning. And so, and now we can see some of the results of that. So, like I said, very disappointed with the image of what I was imagining Bali to be like and what it has been. So after talking to the hordes of hawkers along the beach, one of the interesting things they said is that the rubbish is being blown from the other island, Java, and being washed up onto Kuta Beach. And also, it's in their interest that they've been helping to clean up. So it's in their interest that the beach is good, that the people, the tourists like to come to the beach. They like to come to the beach, relax on the beach, so that they can generate more business. And that they're certainly very enthusiastic in approaching tourists and trying to sell them a range of different things, but they're also helping up in the cleanup. So they know that the environment is part of the attraction of coming to Kuta, and they know that when they have a good environment, then tourism will flourish even more. And also behind me, in the tractor, you can see that the guys in the green are from the council. So they're the government employees who are paid to clean up. So you've got the street hawkers, who voluntarily are cleaning up, as well as the council, the government, the public sector, who will make an effort to also clean up the beach. But as I said, the rubbish is really very overwhelming and quite a surprise from what I expected.
This cleanup, while necessary, could be avoided if the rubbish wasn't washed up on the beach in the first place.
Pollution on the beach, another standout problem in Bali for tourism is congestion. The traffic is manic, bumper to bumper, scooters, cars, trucks, vans, everything trying to compete. It takes a long time to get a very short distance. Another problem for tourism in Bali.
Here's an example of the traffic. A short taxi ride, like to go from Seminyak to Kuta, which is only a few kilometres, took about 45 minutes. The last issue I look at is the issue of land and water use, where tourism, and particularly hotels, can deprive the local community of their natural resources.
I'm just outside of Kuta in the suburb of Seminyak, and it's a little bit less densely populated, less dense in terms of buildings. And so you can still see there's some, like, you've got rice paddies next to hotels. I find this quite interesting, but you've got to wonder in terms of the long-term sustainability, whether these rice paddies are going to stay, and whether tourism, the industry, will just subsume all this land and buy these farmers out and become more and more densely populated as a tourist destination. Rice paddy. Sheraton.
Water parks are great fun, attracting many tourists, especially families, but they do use lots of water that can be used in other ways. I don't mind going for a slide.
Okay, so I've raised two important issues for tourism in Bali. One was the rubbish up on the beach. What's the solution? I wonder if you readers have any ideas. I'm going to ponder some solutions while I'm getting my feet massaged. Another great thing to do in Indonesia. One way would be obviously to stop the rubbish at the source, in Java, to stop people throwing their rubbish into the sea. In terms of solutions, you can see that there was lots of cleanup happening, but by then it's already too late. Not to say about the quality of water and the marine life and the impact of the marine life. Second is the traffic. Now there's been some one-way streets, I guess, to help the flow, or too many vehicles compared to the amount of people and the amount of space. One way could be to pedestrianize some streets and bring in some transport from outside, so that there's no traffic at all in the heavily densely populated areas. But in all, there's no easy solution. But it's something that tourism policymakers need to think about.